Welcome back. Now that we've mastered the three rigid transformations, let's start putting those moves together. Since Mia slid across the screen, that's a translation. And then Mia flipped. Oh, that's a reflection. This is an example of a sequence of transformations, which is two or more transformations applied in order to a pre-image. Today, you'll see different combinations of translations, reflections, and rotations. Before we go any further in this video, you'll need to complete the satellite simulations activity that comes before your guided notes. If you haven't done that yet, pause the video now and come back when you're finished. Okay, let's dance. Here's an example of a sequence of transformations. We want to first reflect the pre-image over the y-axis and then translate 6 units up. Notice that we use words like first and then because in a sequence, we perform transformations in a specific order. We also need to write a single coordinate notation to describe the transformation from the pre-image to the final image. We'll want an organizer to keep track of how the coordinates change throughout the sequence.
Let's first record the coordinates of our pre-image. Go ahead and pause to fill that out. And here they are. Take a second to review your coordinates. Okay, now let's perform the first transformation in the sequence. Reflecting the pre-image over the y-axis. When reflecting, remember that all the new points are the same distance from the line of reflection as the original points. Go ahead and draw that reflection in your guided notes and record those new coordinates here. Pause the video now. Since point B is 3 units to the left of the y-axis, point B prime will be 3 units to the right of the y-axis. We use the same strategy to plot the other 3 points, creating A, B, C, D prime. And here are its coordinates. What's the coordinate notation that describes the reflection? We know that a reflection over the y-axis only changes the sign of the x-coordinate, so negative x, y is the coordinate notation. Okay, now let's move to our next transformation in the sequence, translating 6 units up. Since we're performing a second transformation, we can actually label these coordinates as double prime, which uses a double apostrophe. Pause now to translate ABCD prime 6 units up and record the new coordinates. After shifting each prime point up 6 units, ABCD double prime should look like this, and these are its coordinates. How did the coordinates from the first step to the image change? Only the y-coordinate changed, increasing by 6, so we can write x, y plus 6 as the coordinate notation. Now we want to write a single coordinate notation to describe the transformation from the pre-image to the final image. So it needs to summarize the reflection and translation that has taken place. Let's start by looking at everything that happened to the x-coordinate from both transformations. The reflection changed the sign of the x-coordinate to its opposite. The translation did not affect the new x-coordinate. That means the x-coordinate of the final image remains the opposite of the x-coordinate of the pre-image. So we can write negative x on the coordinate notation. Now let's look at everything that happened to the y-coordinate. How did the y-coordinate change? the reflection didn't affect the y-coordinate, but the translation increased the y-coordinate by 6. This means that throughout the sequence, the y-coordinate of the pre-image only increased by 6 to become the y-coordinate of the final image. So we can write y plus 6 on the coordinate notation. And that's our single coordinate notation, negative x, comma, y plus 6. How can we confirm that this coordinate notation is correct? We can apply it to one of our coordinates to check. If we take point A, change the sign of the x-coordinate from negative 5 to positive 5, and add 6 to the y-coordinate, we'll get 5, 7, which matches the coordinates of point A double prime. This coordinate notation is indeed correct.
When working with sequences of transformations, it can feel like there's a lot of information, but as long as you take it step by step, you'll do just fine. Here's a checklist that you may find helpful. It reminds us to perform transformations in order with proper labeling, organize coordinates and their notations so we can more easily observe changes, and check whether the single coordinate notation is accurate by applying it to a pre-image coordinate. Okay, let's apply what we've learned so far to two more sequences.
In this sequence, we are shifting the pre-image 11 units left and 3 units up, followed by a 90-degree counterclockwise rotation around the origin. What's the first transformation in the sequence? Yeah, a translation 11 units left and 3 units up. Draw the figure after the translation and record the coordinates of RST prime in the table. Pause the video now. The translations create RST prime with these coordinates. Take a moment to compare your image and coordinates with what's shown here. How did the coordinates change? The translations decreased the x-coordinate by 11 and increased the y-coordinate by 3. What coordinate notation describes this? We can write x minus 11, y plus 3 as the coordinate notation. What's our next transformation? A 90-degree counterclockwise rotation around the origin. There are different strategies for performing a rotation, and we know that the coordinate notation for a 90-degree counterclockwise rotation is negative y, x. Take a moment to perform the rotation to find RST double prime. Pause now and come back once you're done. If we use the coordinate notation, we know that we need to switch the coordinates and the y value changes signs to its opposite. Compare your coordinates with what's shown. Okay. Now, we can plot these coordinates to create RST double prime on the coordinate plane. Our final step is to write a single coordinate notation to describe the sequence of transformations, summarizing the changes on the coordinates from both the translation and rotation. Looking at the coordinate notation for the translation, we know that our x-coordinate decreased by 11. How did the rotation affect the x-coordinate? The rotation switched its place. So how did the x-coordinate change overall? The x-coordinate of the pre-image decreased by 11 and becomes the new y-coordinate of the final image. So we can write x minus 11 as the new y-coordinate in our coordinate notation. Let's look at how the y-coordinate of the pre-image changed. The translation increased the y-coordinate by 3. How did the rotation affect the y-coordinate? The rotation switched its place to the x-coordinate and changed it to its opposite. Summarizing this, the y-coordinate was increased by 3 and switched to the x-coordinate with an opposite sign. So, we can write negative parentheses y plus 3 as the new x-coordinate of the final image. How can we simplify this to find the opposite of y plus 3? We can distribute this negative sign, giving us negative y minus 3. And here's our completed coordinate notation. Let's check to confirm whether our coordinate notation is correct by applying it to point r at 2, 1. We subtract the x-coordinate of 2 by 11 to get negative 9 and switch it to the y-coordinate. The y-coordinate of positive 1 becomes negative 1 and subtracts 3, which is negative 4, and it switches to the x-coordinate. Does this r double prime match what's recorded? Yes, it does, confirming to us that our coordinate notation is correct. Let's look at another example. In this sequence, we're rotating the pre-image 180 degrees clockwise around the origin, and then flipping over the x-axis. The first transformation is the 180 degree rotation, and here is its coordinate notation. Take a moment to fill out these first two columns and plot xyz prime on the coordinate plane. Pause the video now and come back once you're ready. The pre-image consists of points x, y, and z, and after a 180 degree rotation, xyz prime will have these coordinates. Take a moment to ensure your coordinates match what's on the screen. And here is xyz prime. Let's move on to our next transformation, a reflection over the x-axis. Go ahead and reflect xyz prime over the x-axis and fill out this last column with the new coordinates. You may use this coordinate notation to help you reflect. Pause the video now. And here is xyz double prime and its coordinates. Next step is to write a single coordinate notation to describe this entire sequence. Go ahead and give it a shot. Come back once you're ready. Let's see how the x-coordinate of the pre-image changed. The rotation changed the sign of the x-coordinate to its opposite, and the reflection did not affect the new x-coordinate at all. That means the x-coordinate of the image is still the opposite of the x-coordinate of the pre-image, meaning we can simply write negative x in our coordinate notation. Let's see how the y-coordinate of the pre-image changed. The rotation changed the sign of the y-coordinate to its opposite. Opposite of 0 is just 0. Opposite of negative 3 is 3, and opposite of negative 2 is 2. The reflection actually changed the sign of the y-coordinate again, 0 to 0, 3 to negative 3, and 2 to negative 2. Whoa, that means the y-coordinate became its opposite, not just once, but 2 times, which means a negative, negative y. If we compare the x-coordinates of the pre-image and image, they didn't seem to change, and that's because the opposite of y is just y. And here's our coordinate notation. Let's check whether it's correct. If we apply this coordinate notation to point y, what would we get? The negative 4 becomes its opposite, and the negative 3 stays the same. And that matches y double prime, confirming that our coordinate notation is correct.
Great work performing sequences of transformations and writing coordinate notations to represent them. Now it's time to apply what you've learned to some practice levels. And don't forget, math is everywhere. Keep exploring. Hey, hey.